Welcome to the desert and inside Chase Field in Phoenix. An NL West matchup on the show. It's the San Diego Padres and the Arizona Diamondbacks. First pitch coming at you right after the break. Ready to go now and towing the slab, Merrill Kelly. What do we need to know here?
A very forgettable start his last time out. Was only able to work a couple of innings. We're looking for him to put it all together today. Command, tempo, and just really a confident presence out there on the mound.
So just about set now. Stepping in, Jake Cronenworth. The line and the pitch. Out to short. That takes care of Cronenworth. As we take a look at the Padres lineup. All right, Siggy, how about all the talent in this lineup?
They're deep, first and foremost, but the way that they can manipulate their personnel for matchups and everything else, it's very intelligent the way that they use their team. And I think it creates a little bit of uncertainty for opposing teams, especially in a big game, big series.
The wind of the pitch. Trent Grisham takes a strike there as he stands at the plate now. No score, just getting started, top of the first. Next pitch is downstairs. Falling behind 2-1. Check swing, but he went too far. 2-2. Righty delivers. Stays alive. That one wrapped foul. Eighth pitch of the at bat coming up. Next one just misses. Full count, 3-2. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
Well, that's a nice job of grinding out that at bat. Saw a lot of pitches and ends up drawing the walk. Very gritty.
So man aboard, one down, and it's Tatis at the plate. Kelly back to work. In there at the knees. That's strike one. Fernando Tatis Jr. continues to be one of the most dynamic talents in the game. That season he put together in 2021, one of the best in Padres history. Tatis waits.
This is one of those situations defensively where you can't try to do too much. You got to make sure that you field the ball cleanly and get one out first. It's going to be tough to get two with this kind of speed in the batter's box.
Grisham leads off first with one away. Next offering is down low.
Yes, such a special player at a young age. He led the National League in home runs in just his third season in the bigs, and he went on the injured list twice in that season.
Next pitch is outside. Chris, with that distraction and a speedy guy at first, he's in a favorable hitter's count.
Well, if nothing else, I mean, this is a great spot for a hitter to be in.
The pitch. And ball four, two aboard.
Batting four, the designated hitter.
Luke Voit now at the plate. Voit. Coming off a big game last night with five runs driven in. The pitch. There's the strike. Next offering is in for a strike.
Well, he didn't like those first two pitches. Now in an 0-2 hole, he's going to have to battle, hope he gets a mistake. One guy that was really great once the count got to two strikes, Miguel Cabrera.
The next offering misses, and it's 1-2.
Pretty standard high 0-2 fastball right there. If you're smart, you'll look for something down in the zone, but not too far. Don't want to chase that breaking ball in the dirt.
Next offering is downstairs.
Well, Boog, early on in this one, having a hard time getting settled in. He's not showing control to throw strikes, and let alone to throw it where he wants in the strike zone. This could be a tough one for him.
The next pitch misses. Counts full, 3-2.
That's a really good take.
One out. Runners at first and second. Fought off foul. At the belt and fires. And down on strikes. And the Padres waste a chance.
Well, he should get some fist bumps when he gets back into the dugout, because even though he strikes out, he saw a lot of pitches and he battled. And this is a long haul where you're trying to get that pitch count up as early as possible. So gave the guys behind him an opportunity to see what's working for this pitcher or not. But I tell you what, it's a nice job right there.
Here's Manny Machado. And he swings and misses at the initial offering.
Well, with this many pitches thrown here in this first inning, I mean, you're giving the other team a really good look. He's going to have to find a way to get some weak contact, maybe a swing and miss, get into that dugout and hit the reset button.
The pitch. Bottom of the zone and a called strike. And Machado able to spoil that pitch. And the right-hander deals. And that one is lifted in the air. He can't get there. It's a base hit. Runner around third in to score. The tag, and that's out number three, inning over. So one run on one hit, no errors, and a runner left. On to the bottom of the first. It's the Padres 1 and the D-backs coming up. And on the mound in this one, Joe Musgrove.
Well, a very solid ERA last season, just a little over 3. And when you've got a guy like that taking the mound for you, the offense is definitely expected to score 4 runs at least, unless they're really struggling. So you know, more times than not, when he's on the bump, you're going to win the ball game if you just do your part as an offense. So last year, great year. He wants to repeat that or even improve. And I think there is some room for improvement. He's got good stuff. It's just executing from hitter to hitter.
Next offering is in for a strike.
Well, we call that keyholing. Even though it's right there and looks pretty good, if he doesn't love it, he's not going to swing that early in the count.
That one ripped. Grisham makes the grab, and there's one away.
Batting second.
Time to take a look at the Diamondbacks lineup. Already trailing by a run in this one, they'll be looking to get on the scoreboard early on as well.
Well, it's just the one run, so not too big a hill to climb. But, yeah, if they can answer back in this inning or at least in the next couple, that'll maybe settle everyone into this ball game, and that includes their own starter on the mound.
The wind of the pitch. Paven Smith stands in now and lets that one go for a strike. The 0-1 is outside, and it's a ball and a strike. Left-hand hitter waits. Breaking ball, and that got him. He had 2 strikes on him, And he hit him.
Well, it looks like he wanted that slider to finish on the inside part of the plate, not start on the inside and end up hitting the batter. It looked to me like he just tried to do a little too much with that one.
Ketel Marte looks at one outside there. The 1-0.
Last two pitches have been down in the zone. Pitcher clearly trying to get that ground ball double play. But in this count, he's going to have to give in, elevate his pitches, and get back into this at bat.
2-0.
Well, with the amount of pitches that can end up in the dirt, a good secondary lead doesn't have to get away from the catcher. But if you're anticipating based off the trajectory, get yourself into scoring position.
Well, just came apart right there. Four-pitch walk, and guy at the plate was not going to help him out by swinging at something out of the zone.
And now it's Christian Walker. Here comes the pitch. On the ground, two ball to Tatis for the pivot. There's one, and that's two.
Pitcher made the pitch, and his players made the play behind him. Nice job, 4-6-3, inning ending double play.
Back here in the desert, top of the second, Pierce Hosmer.
Leading off for the Padres, the first baseman, Eric Hosmer.
Here we go, guys. Come on.
The pitch. And that clips the inside corner.
He needs a quick 1-2-3 this time around. Last inning, threw a lot of pitches.
Why to kick the pitch. And a foul ball, third base side. Oh and two now. Up the middle, Alcantara handles. Throw to first is in time. Leadoff man retired here in the second.
Batting seven. The right fielder number five.
Will Myers, who goes with no batting gloves. The right-hander back to work. And that one clips the corner. Next pitch is downstairs. Gary Simmons, our plate umpire today, sort of has a reputation as a pitcher's umpire.
Yeah, a little bit of a wider zone than most, I'd say. And a wide zone can be tough to deal with as a hitter because you have to start expanding what you're looking for, covering both sides, and with the stuff guys have today, you're just not going to have a lot of success.
Gets it to first. Two up, two down. Singy, what kind of strike zone is most frustrating for hitters?
I'd say off the plate, away, and down. And why? Those are the toughest locations to hit the baseball.
Here's Nomar Mazara. Didn't play in the day game yesterday, so he should be fresh for this one. As the game has moved along, we see more and more information supplied by teams about the umpires. I've been in clubhouses where they have pictures of all four guys, nicknames, hometowns, and as well hobbies listed, just so you can kind of small talk the umpire a little bit.
That's great.
Next one misses, and it's 1-1. On the ground, right side, whips it to first. Out number three. Nothing doing there for the Friars, but they still lead it 1-0. Back here at Chase Field, now it's the rookie DH, Seth Beer.
For the Diamondbacks, the designated hitter, Seth. Beer.
And he deals. Caught at first by Hosmer.
Batting fifth. The left fielder. Dig back.
Digging in, David Peralta. He's sitting on 99 career homers. We'll see if this is the moment to notch number 100.
Possibly thinking about home run number 100 here. He's just one shy of that milestone.
Next pitch is inside. And now it's even 1-1. On the ground. Dives and he can't hang on. That leaves him without a throw and they can't get the out.
Batting seven. The center fielder. Duncan. Barsho.
And now it's Dalton Barsho. Looking to rebound today. He was 0-for-4 last night. And a pitch. Ball one low. And look out. That one gets him. The second man he's plunked in this one.
Well, he didn't miss by much right there, but it was just enough to clip him on the way in.
2-on-1 out. And now the batter is Carson Kelly. He was 1-for-4 back on Wednesday. In the dirt, but kept close.
The offense really struggled last night. I mean, it was awful. So I think picking up a run right here, that's going to get him going a little bit.
Next offering upstairs.
Good spot for the hitter. Definitely has the advantage in this count with runners on. Look for him to be aggressive on this next pitch.
Here's a 2-1. And that one fouled off.
He's gone off speed. He needs to elevate here with two strikes out of the zone.
And the righty deals. In the dirt, blocked. But no advance from the runners. And here it comes. Fouled off again. And it remains 3-2. Peralta, the lead runner at second. Barsho at first. One gone. And that one fouled off. Three balls, two strikes the count. Grounded to third. Could be two. To second. Pulls him off the bag. So bases loaded with one away. Now up next for Arizona, Sergio Alcantara.
He's been such a good hitter with runners in scoring position. Some guys just take it to another level. For him right now at the plate, it's like everyone else is in slow motion and he's in full speed. I think ultimately you want to tie him up, get the ball in on the plate so that he can't get the barrel to it and hit it to the outfield.
And the pitch. Misses. Now 1-2.
He's looking for a ground ball to get a double play and out of this jam.
Bases loaded. One away. Tapped softly on the ground. Fires to first, but the runner scores from third. Thought they had a shot at him at the plate.
Up next to the Diamondbacks, the third baseman.
Here's the Diamondbacks leadoff hitter, Josh Rojas. He's 0-for-1.
And this is a big opportunity for him to pick up his teammate right here.
The pitch. That one misses. 1-0.
He's got a base open, so the pressure to come in and really attack this hitter, not as great as it would be if the bags were sacked.
Left-hand batter waits. Swing and a ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit. One run is in. Not in time. He's safe.
Well, he had the opportunity to drive in some runs, and he comes through to break the tie. Really nice job staying up the middle with this approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch. Just shot it through the infield.
Haven Smith stands in now for the Diamondbacks. Musgrove with a move to first. And he's back in safely. And a pitch. And ball one to the right fielder. There's a strike.
Looks like he's just sizing him up there. Really good pitch to hit, but he took it all the way. Sometimes guys just want to set their timing later on in the game. That may be a pitch that he turns on.
In the dirt, gets away from Nola. No advance, though. Kicks and deals. Good eye right there. Three-1 is on the way. Foul ball there.
Great RBI spot here. Just got to stay focused on the pitch. The runner will be in motion, so something in the gap should definitely score it.
Right-hander kicks, deals. In the air on the infield. Cronenworth makes the catch, and that'll do it. We play two full. It's the Diamondbacks 3 and the Padres 1. Welcome back, and now it's Austin Nola.
Leading off for San Diego.
Well, after putting up a nice Austin inning on offense, got some runs across, this is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team any hope. You just hope that he can get through this inning, get the bats back up there while they're hot.
The 0-1. Just missed. And that's a strike. The 1-2. Just missing there. And the count's even at 2. Swing and a line drive caught.
The batter number 9, second baseman, Jake Cronenworth.
So up next, Jake Cronenworth. And the right hander back to work. There's a strike. Next pitch misses, and the count is 1-2. And that chance handled. Throws to first. First two batters retired here in the top of the third.
The center fielder, number 2, Trent Grisham.
Now it's Trent Grisham to the plate. A walk and a run scored his first time. We talk about guys with good speed, and definitely he has it. But pushing the offense aside for just a second, Chris, it's the defensive side that I think the speed factors in the most. Yoan. Swing and a miss. No balls, two strikes.
Well, he gets to balls that get by most people at that position. Just really impressive, because there are certain times the ball comes off the bat, automatically that team that hit it thinks that they've got a base hit, or they may have extra bases, and he just takes it away.
The other way. Padres go down quietly. Score holds. It's 3-1. And welcome back. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. An outstanding hitter in Ketel Marte.
All around, I think if you asked anyone in this organization, who's the best hitter in the lineup, they would say him.
A wind and a pitch. And a foul ball. The 0-1. And misses inside. Out to short. Tatis handles that chance. Slings it across. One gone, bottom of the third inning.
Now batting, the first baseman.
And next will be the cleanup hitter, Christian Walker. Musgrove back to work. Inside corner, and that's called a strike. Strike two. Next pitch downstairs. 1-2 to count. Next one misses. Yeah, that's ball two.
Two balls, two strikes.
Next pitch is popped up. Hosmer pulls it down, two away down.
The batter, the designated hitter, Seth.
Two outs, bases empty. So next is the designated hitter for the D-backs, Seth Beer. The pitch lifted in the air, right center field. Myers has this one sized up, makes the grab, and that ends the inning. And the Diamondbacks down in order, and the score stays 3-1. Back here at the ballpark, John Ciambi with Chris Singleton, and set to lead off the fourth, Fernando Tatis Jr.
Fernando Tatis Jr.
The pitch. That's inside.
It's good speed at the top of the order here. You want to get it on, see if you can get a stolen base, maybe get around the bases and pick up a run.
The next offering misses. Two balls, no strikes to count. The 2-0 is in for a strike.
Man, this guy's got a great feel for his breaking ball today.
That's a bullet, but it goes foul. Kicks and fires. Got him swinging. Leadoff hitter retired in the fourth.
Tell you what, those are the types of guys pitchers really like to punch out when they're on the mound, because if they get on, just the distraction that they create with all that speed over on the base pass, it could take away your focus from the next hitter, and that's the last thing you want to do, is serve up a pitch that a guy hits over the fence, and it's a multi-run home run.
And here's Luke Voit. in there, and it's 0-1.
Boog, over 80% of his first pitches are strikes. You're doing that, you could have a really good day out there on the mound.
And he's down 0-2 as he swings through it.
The guy's going this good. He's retired 7 in a row. You got to step out of the box, fake bunt, do something to break it up.
The next pitch misses. Going to count 1-2.
Well, that's kind of what you expect in an 0-2 count. Excellent job of the hitter to have the plate discipline to lay off of that pitch.
Comes up empty as he chases that one in the dirt. Out on the drop, third strike, two gone.
The third baseman, number 13, Manny Machado.
Two outs, base is empty. And now it's Manny Machado, doubled his first time up. Singing, you can't ask for anything more. This guy checks all the boxes offensively.
He is the ultimate professional, and it doesn't just start at game time. It starts in the afternoon, the way he prepares and gets ready for the ball game. I tell you what, his teammates feed off of the leadership that he shows on and off the field.
The pitch. Line to second, snagged on the bounce. Fires over to first. Machado out of the play. Third out to the bottom of inning number 4 now. It's the Diamondbacks 3 and the Padres 1. Back here in the desert, bottom of the fourth, here's the left fielder, David Peralta.
The Diamondback, the left fielder, Jason.
The wind of the pitch.
Peralta.
And first offering is fouled off. Next pitch misses, and that is ball one. On the ground to third. Gathers and throws to first. One up, one down. Pretty good job on the mound in this one, Siggy. It feels like we've seen a lot of off-balance swings.
Yeah, just one free pass, and obviously he's not a big strikeout guy, but he gets soft contact and he gets outs.
And now, Dalton Varsho. The wind of the pitch. That's inside, and that's ball one. Next offering in the dirt, and that's ball two.
Not showing great command so far in this at bat. 2-0 count. He's got to execute here, or this could get ugly.
Up the middle, sneaks through, base hit.
Just kept it simple. Played pepper with the middle of the infield and took it back where it came from. And there's just no one there to knock it down.
Carson Kelly stands in now for the Diamondbacks. The pitch. Breaking ball in there for a strike. Varsho, the runner at first with one gone in the inning. Musgrove throws over. Varsho back in on a dive. Next pitch is outside.
He's been trying to tease the zone with that slider, but these hitters have showed patience not going outside the strike zone.
Next offering is down low. Here's the pitch. Run around the goal. On the ground, right side. And that's a base hit. Oh, he throws it away.
Not much to this one other than just a willingness to go the other way and put the ball in play. That's a team at bat right there. Nice job of staying back and letting the ball get deep.
Now here is Sergio Alcantara. And he deals. Ball one there. Two on, one out. Now 3-0. Meanwhile, activity in the bullpen. Denelson Lamet getting loose out there. Down. Runners are at the corners, one away. 3-1, and he couldn't come up with it.
Well, the stage has been set for this offense, Bull. It's all about creating opportunities, and this is one of them right here.
Now the third baseman, Josh Rojas. And he's already singled in this game. The right-hander back to work. That catches the outside corner, and that is strike one. One out, bases full. That one the other way, puts it away for the out.
Yeah, that was a wasted RBI opportunity, but competitor like him, he is looking forward to making up for it in his next at bat.
Payton Smith stands in now for the Diamondbacks.
Oh, he's so good about trying to drive the ball to the opposite field gap in these situations. If he takes that approach, he could bust this game wide open.
Here comes a pitch. Ball one, no strikes. Next offering is in for a strike.
Well, I know they've gotten out to an early lead, but you don't want to take these opportunities for granted. With two outs, still lock in with a quality at bat, drive in that run. You may not have another guy in scoring position the rest of this ballgame.
And that one hit to first. Here's a 1-2. Rips one to right. Base hit. One run is in. In there safely.
Fix himself up a couple of ribbies. Kind of a risky pitch coming inside with the breaking ball like that. You have to bury it. Otherwise, it's not too difficult to get the bat to it like he did that time.
Here's Ketel Marte. And a pitch. Line drive, brings it in for the third out. On to the top of the fifth we go. It's the Diamondbacks 5 and the Padres 1. Back here at Chase Field, and now the first baseman, Eric Hosmer. The Padres in striking distance, but have some work to do.
Boog, it starts with the leadoff man. I need a good at-bat out of him right here.
They've got a potent lineup, and when you think about teams capable of rallying from this kind of deficit, they're right at the top of the list. Pitch is in there. Strike one. Swing and a ball lifted left field. He dives, but he can't make the catch.
Now batting, right fielder.
So man aboard. So digging in now for San Diego, Will Myers. Grounded out his first time. And a pitch. And first offering is fouled off. And the right-hander deals. Grounder might be two. fires to second for one, now to first, and it's a double play.
For me, that's one of the toughest double plays to turn on the infield. The first baseman has to get inside, create a throwing lane to hit that middle infielder to start the double play, and then from there, completing it back to first. Really good job all the way around.
Two outs, base is empty. Stepping in for San Diego, Nomar Mazara. And first offering is fouled off. Left-hand hitter waits. Next offering is outside. Fouled off. He was late. Next one misses. Two balls, two strikes to count with two outs. Next one just misses. And now it's 3-2. The wind to kick the pitch. The right-hander gives up the two-out walk.
What a battle. It's not always easy laying off a 3-2 pitch, and I tell you what, he earned that walk.
Austin Nola, the next up for the Padres. And a pitch. And first offering is fouled off.
Well, you can't really adjust your game plan for that last pitch. Guy hasn't thrown it very much. You got to focus on the stuff that he's throwing up there most of the time.
Righty to the plate. This one in the dirt. Now throw to first, but back easily. Nice job behind the plate there. Checks his swing. Now it appeal to first. And James Kingsley says he won a round. One left for San Diego. They're down 5-1. Bottom of the inning. Here's the cleanup hitter for the Diamondbacks. Christian Walker.
For the Diamondbacks, the first baseman.
The pitch.
Walker.
And it's fouled away. The 0-1. Right side. Tosses to first. And the leadoff man set down in their half of the fifth.
Good late bite on that slider. Got the hitter out front. Rolled over on it. Exactly what it was supposed to do.
And now the DH, Seth Beer. The pitch. And that one missing low. And the 1-0. Pulled down the line. This one hammered, but it's foul.
Clearly hoping he could get a swing and miss on that, but doesn't fool the hitter with that breaking ball. Nice job. Just couldn't keep it fair.
The next offering misses. Two balls and a strike. One down, base is empty. That's down and in. Line drive, that's a base hit out of the left center field. Around first and hustling for second. And that's a double.
I love the approach he had right there with that pitch. Not trying to do too much, but still looking to drive it. And that's exactly what he's able to do into the opposite field gap for the double.
And the Padres manager making his way towards the mound as he will make the move. Joe Musgrove is done in this one. We'll be back in a minute with a new arm on the mound. So they turn things over to the righty, Denelson LeMet. A runner on second to deal with. He'll do his best to keep him there.
So at this point of the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and he needs a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
David Peralta at the plate. And the pitch. Slider misses outside. And there's a ball.
That's a really good take right there. Slider down and in. Very difficult to get on the same plane and do anything with.
And there's the automatic. He swings and fouls one off. And a swing and a miss at the slider in the dirt. Gets the out, two down after the strikeout. Next to hit for Arizona, Dalton Varsho. The pitch. And takes low for ball one.
Ball one, no strike.
Two outs with a runner at third. Next pitch misses way outside.
Last couple of pitches breaking balls away. I think he's going to have to come firm inside to be able to open up that location if he wants to go back there later in this count.
The 2-0 is in for a strike.
That fastball at the bottom of the zone can be very effective. Just got to keep it on the corners.
At the belt and fires. Missing inside. 3-1 now.
Well, he's so great about hitting the ball the other way. He gets those arms extended. So right there, just trying to straighten him up a little bit so he doesn't have as much outside plate coverage.
And here it comes. Fouls one away, and now 3-2. Beer on third with two out. And a foul ball, he stays alive. This ball's chopped to the ground. That's the third out. One left for Arizona. They're up 5-1. And welcome back. New inning getting started. Up now, the Padre leadoff man, Jake Cronenworth.
Second baseman, Jake.
The pitch. A bit behind with that swing. It's strike one.
He's been very consistent with his command out there on the mound, consistently throwing at the knees. Pretty impressive when a guy can repeat his delivery like this.
And the righty deals. In the air, left field, down the line, and now maybe extra bases. Not in time. That's a leadoff double.
Just a blue pit behind third right there, and that's a really tough play for a third baseman or shortstop to get to, and the same for the left fielder. So he just found a perfect place to drop that one in right there. Could be a chance here for them to start clawing back into this ballgame.
So man aboard. Now it's Trent Grisham to the plate. Kelly back to work. Swings through that one for strike one. No outs. Runner on second. Oh, and two as he waves at that one.
Not a swing you want to watch again.
And it's second. Stays alive. Got him. Not what you're looking for after the leadoff double. A strikeout, and there's one away.
No, that's almost just up not fair with that pitch. I mean, until the very last second, Fernando looked like it was going to be well in off the plate, Junior. But the arm side run brought it right back to catch the inside corner. Tell you what, frustrating as a hitter, you give up on the pitch. I honestly don't know what you're supposed to do with that as a hitter other than just tip your cap as you walk back to the dugout.
And the batter will be Fernando Tatis Jr. Here comes the pitch. And a good eye there. Runner at second here, one gone. The next pitch misses, and it's 2-0.
Looking to get something going, this is the guy you want at the plate. He's been great for this team. He is a professional hitter.
Righty delivers. There's a strike, and it's 2-1 now.
That curveball's been a big pitch for him today. He's been able to get ahead in the count with it. He's also been able to use it to put guys away.
Here's a chopper to short. And they take care of Tatis for the out.
Now batting, designated hitter, Lee Ward.
And Luke Voit climbs in. The right hander back to work. And first offering is fouled off. Right hander kicks, deals. And now it's even up. On the ground, right side. That's a base hit as a run scores.
Picks himself up an RBI. Just a simple ground ball the other way that had eyes on it, man. Sometimes that's all you need to do. Just let the ball travel, put the ball in play, and just hope it finds a hole.
So two down. Here's the third baseman, Manny Machado. And a pitch. And Manny gets a piece. Two outs. And a strike.
He must have been looking for something else because he gave up on that pitch a little early. It was right down Main Street. probably not going to see a better pitch to hit in this at bat.
Next offering misses. Now 1-2.
0-2 curve right there. Hitter kind of expects that, and good job of just showing that confidence and trying to get back into this count.
Voit off of first with two away. Swing and a hard hit liner up the middle to base hit. Throw in holds the lead runner at second. Two on now with two away.
Really nice job of two strike hitting in that at bat. Everything was on time and fluid in that swing. Got a pitch you could get the barrel on and lined it into center for the knock. Those always feel good.
Now it's Eric Hosmer. The pitch. That one ripped. He's got it. And that is out number three. So one run in the inning on this base hit. It's now 5-2. You see how hot my degrees be. You see them jock trying to beat me. It's only one man, believe me. Believe me. Believe me. It's only one man. Back here at the ballpark, and now the batter is Carson Kelly.
With this kind of lead, he can swing freely. Try to hit the ball out of the park. Do what he loves to do.
Kelly.
A wind in the pitch. And ball one. Activity in the bullpen for San Diego. Pierce Johnson getting ready to come in for Bob Melvin. Garcia warming up as well. Taps softly to the right side. Hosmer steps on the bag, and that's one out as they get the leadoff hitter in the sixth.
Throw a well-thrown slider like that one can be tough to get in the air. Good downward break on that one.
Next up for the Diamondbacks, Sergio Alcantara. This is a guy who's in the lineup first and foremost because of what he contributes defensively, Chris. And when you talk about preventing runs from being scored, this guy is a big contributor. And the 0-1. That misses the zone. And the count even 1-1.
I was always told it's hard to take you off the field when you play really good defense, especially at a premier position. And that's what he does.
Next offering is in the dirt. That hits the dirt. And now 3-1. Next offering finds the zone, and the count is full. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Second walk of the game for him, and he's been really patient at the plate. The game plan that he's sticking to, he's just not going outside of what he's looking for up there.
And a pitch. Rojas watches that one for a strike, standing in here with one down. Comes up empty on the swing, 0-2 now.
Two pretty nasty sliders to get this hitter in an 0-2 count. If you're up there at the plate, you got to look up in the zone and spit on anything that's down.
One ball.
And 1-2. And that one handled. To Tatis for the pivot. There's one. Back to first, double play. And that's it for the inning. Seventh inning coming up. It's the Diamondbacks 5 and the Padres 2. Welcome back. We go to the top of the seventh. So digging in now for San Diego, Will Myers.
The right fielder, number 5, Will Myers.
The wind of the pitch. Down the left field line. Should be extra bases. Takes the turn. He's digging for second. Throw, and it gets away.
Just a really nice job of turning on that pitch and smoking it down the line. And there's no one playing there. So once it drops in fair, you're on your way to extra bases.
Manager out of the dugout, and he's going to make a change. Merrill Kelly is done, and he's responsible for the runner on second. So the book isn't closed on him yet. We'll be right back. Now on the mound for the Diamondbacks, Caleb Smith. He'll try to strand the runner at second.
Well, I think that what makes him so tough against left-handers is he hides the ball for a long time. And from that same side, harder for you to determine which part of the plate it's going to end up on.
Here's Nomar Mazara. And a pitch.
If you're going to get something going, this is the time to do it. You get the leadoff man on. Everybody's got to look over the shoulder and say, I'm just going to keep the line moving. Don't try to do too much.
Kicks and deals. Out towards right center field. He's in there. And he's in safely at third with one out.
Now batting.
Was able to move the runner up to third on that deep fly to center, but I think this point he wants to get him over and get him in.
The pitch. Soft contact in the air. Marte makes the play. Two down.
The batter number 9, second baseman, Jake Cronenworth.
Now it's the second baseman, Jake Cronenworth.
Really good piece of hitting last time, going to the opposite field.
The pitch. Yeah, there's the strike. Action in the pen down there. Mark Melanson up and loosening in the pen. Kennedy getting cranked up as well. Next offering is downstairs. In the dirt, well done behind the dish. Hot shot to third. Rojas goes on to first. And that'll do it. Midway in inning number 7, and it's time to stretch. It's the Diamondbacks 5 and the Padres 2. Back here in the desert, now the number 2 hitter, Paven Smith.
Leading up for the Diamondbacks, the right fielder, Paven.
The right-hander back to work.
Smith.
And a swing and a miss.
Sometimes a hitter will go up there and guess, and it's not just pulling something out of the sky, but expecting because of tendencies a certain pitch in a certain location. He just guessed wrong. I could watch base hits like that one all day long, and so could every hitting coach in the league. Just a nice line drive into center field.
Ketel Marte up to the plate. The pitch. Runner on the go. And that one fouled off. Now Next pitch off the play. Ball one.
No, he's really working him away this at bat. Sometimes take a little bit off velocity. Try to get a rollover, something on the ground. Stay away from that big hole on the right side of the infield.
The 1-1. Nope. And that one upstairs.
Good purpose pitch right there. Trying to tease him, get him to raise his sights, pop something up, and make it an easy out.
Runner goes again. On the ground to the left. And that one finds its way through. Lead runner to second. So two on and nobody out.
Up next for the Diamondbacks, the first baseman.
And now it's Christian Walker.
Walker.
And here it comes. Looked like it was a little bit up. And the right-hander deals. And there's the strike.
It's amazing to look up and see 88 miles per hour on that changeup. Back in the day, that was a pretty good fastball. But with high velocities these days, that speed differential is right where it needs to be.
The 1-1. And another ball.
He's getting a little frustrated out there on the mound, getting hit around a little bit. Let's see if he can settle himself down.
On the ground, left side, 6-4-3, and they turn the double play.
Now batting, the designated hitter, Seth Beer.
Next to hit, Seth Beer for the fourth time tonight. And the pitch off the plate, and it's 1-0. Left-hand hitter waits. That clips the corner.
One ball, one strike.
Runner at third, two away. Next pitch is outside. And it's even up. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And that's the inning. One left for the Diamondbacks. They're still out in front 5-2. Welcome back. And a new arm on the mound to start the eighth. J.B. Wendelken. He's making his second appearance of the season. Back here at Chase Field, digging in, it's the speedy outfielder, Trent Grisham. Singy, you got to appreciate a guy who's this good defensively. I mean, watching him track balls in the outfield, it is beautiful. The pitch. Misses off the inside, and that's ball one.
He's so solid, calms the heart rate of the pitcher and the manager when the ball goes up in the air. You just automatically assume that it's an out every time it's hit in the air.
Left-hand batter waits. Good eye right there. And he deals. And a 2-1 hammered but foul. riding to the plate. Bounce to the right side. Marte throws the first in time. That takes care of Grisham.
The batter, the shortstop, Fernando Tatis Jr.
Fernando Tatis Jr. to hit here. You talk about the power and the speed together.
Well, we knew he was going to be a stud just coming up, making his way through the minor leagues, and quickly at this level, an impact player.
First pitch doesn't find the zone. The 1-0. Good eye in that spot.
Well, it's critical right here that they bear down and turn in some quality at bats, try to chip away at that lead, because if it gets to the ninth, that closer's coming in.
Next one misses, ball three. Here's a 3-0. That's in there. There's a strike. At the belt and fires. Right side, hard hit. That one sizzling on its way through to the outfield.
Just so sound in his mechanics. Hits against a firm front side, and the hands just continue to carry through the middle of the field.
Luke Voit at the plate. And a pitch. Good eye right there.
Here's a run scoring opportunity. You definitely got to push something across because it's not going to get any easier. You get to the ninth, you got a lockdown closer ready to come in.
Kicks and fires. There's a strike. The pitch. So now 1-2.
Knowing that the pitcher wants a ground ball double play opportunity here, you've got to lay off pitches down in the zone. Right there, swinging at that pitch, that's a no-no.
And the righty deals. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him.
Boog gets talked about a lot, but a good high fastball in a two-strike situation, it's just become such a problem for hitters in more recent years. But with all of the emphasis by pitchers on developing that spin rate, having a good grip on the baseball, those high fastballs, they kind of look like to the hitter that they're rising, even though they're not, but they're not decreasing in velocity and spin rate, so very difficult to get the barrel on it.
Here's Machado. First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
Got to keep things airtight defensively right here. On your toes, ready to make a play. If you can get this to the ninth with a three-run lead, it should be a W.
Tatis, the runner at first with two gone. The next offering misses. And 1-1. Here's a 1-1. And now 2-1 after that missed inside. The count 2-1. And that one hammered. That's back there. Knocks it down, and it hits the fence.
Well, they call that an advantage count for a reason. You're so much more likely to get something you can handle. So close to blasting that one out of here the other way, but Well, that's very tough to do when you take on the outfield gap like that. Beautiful swing, though. Let the ball get a little deep and drove it to the opposite field.
Here comes Mark Melancon. He's into the game to face his former team. And now it's Eric Hosmer. And a pitch. And there's the strike. The next pitch misses, and it's a ball and a strike. And it's second. And a count one and two.
Definitely got the hitter conscious of the pitch inside. Really think the outer half is open.
The tying run at the plate. Ground ball right side. Over to first. That ends the inning, and they limit the damage. Padres with the run scoring double. It's now a 5-3 ball game. Ready for the bottom of the eighth, and here is David Peralta.
Leading up for the Diamondbacks, the left fielder,
Jay. The wind of the pitch.
Peralta.
And there's a foul ball. Slapped foul. Fly ball down the line. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. One up, one down.
Maybe caught that one off the end just a little bit. Couldn't quite barrel it up enough to really drive it.
And now it's Dalton Varsho. The wide to kick the pitch. That one finds the corner. 1-1. Right-handed reliever.
One ball, two strikes. Yeah.
And now the count is even. Here comes a pitch. Ground ball up the middle. Throw off line. He's safe. And a nice job there to keep it from getting away.
The catcher. Carson Kelly
stands in now for the Diamondbacks. Lomet over to first. Varsho back on a dive. The pitch. And that one a little bit high. Righty delivers. Here's the pitch. Runner goes. He makes the throw, but it's not in time. And they don't get an out on the play.
Well, he had that base stolen as soon as he broke for second. Such a huge lead. The pitcher's got to find a way to help out his catcher, especially if he doesn't have a great throwing arm. Step off the rubber, shrink that lead, somehow create a little bit more time where maybe you can prevent that stolen base.
Right-hander kicks, deals. misses with the 2-0, and he's fired three straight outside the strike zone. The pitch. One out and a runner at second. And that's ball four.
Maybe a little loss of focus on the mound right there. Pretty much gifted in first base with a quick free pass.
That's shortstop.
Sergio Alcantara will hit next.
The bottom of the order here, Boog. You got to go right after this guy.
As they look to pick up an add-on run. And the number nine guy at the plate. The pitch. And misses inside.
Well, this is a critical spot for both the pitcher and the hitter. You can learn a lot about a guy by how he handles these pressure situations.
Next offering misses. Now 2-0.
If you're the pitcher, you've got to go right at this guy. It's the number nine hitter in the lineup. You can't be afraid of contact in this situation.
Next pitch is outside.
At this point in the game, you cannot issue free passes. He's going to have to challenge this hitter. Hitter's got to be ready to swing it.
Varsho at second. Kelly over at first with one away. In for a strike. Now 3-1. Swing and a miss. 3-2 now.
Really consistent release point. He's been able to pitch up and down and have excellent command at both locations.
Kicks and deals. And a foul ball. Runners at first and second with one gone. Fouled off again. And it remains 3-2. The kick, the 3-2. And a swing and a miss. Down on strikes and two away now.
He came out of his mechanics there. Typically likes to shoot the ball the other way. But that time, a little anxious.
Here's a new pitcher from the pen, Tim Hill. It's his job to keep his team in the game.
Number 25, Tim Hill.
Back to the top of the lineup. Here's Josh Rojas. And a pitch. That one is upstairs. And that's down and away.
2-0.
Two outs. Couple of base runners at first and second. And a big swing and a miss. One fouled off. The 2-2. And now the count filled up 3-2. Two on, two outs. In the air to left center. Tatis under it. That is the inning. Diamondbacks strand a pair, and it remains 5-3. back here at the ballpark. We go to the ninth. Will Myers now.
Off for San Diego, the right fielder, number 5, Will Myers.
The wind of the pitch. That clips the corner.
Getting a little frustrated with the strike zone.
Smith, long run on his horse. Through that, and it's a strikeout. Now one gone in the ninth.
Well, I definitely say that's a statement strikeout right there. You come out of the bullpen, go right after the hitters, and 3 pitches later, you got one out. Tell you what, if you're in the dugout, you're looking at each other and saying, he's going to be tough to get to today.
Now the left fielder, Nomar Mazara. And a pitch. And first offering is fouled off. And here it comes. Ball one low. Next one misses, and a count 2-1. Next pitch misses, 3-1. In for a strike. Now it's 3-2. Started after it. Appeal to third. And yes, he did. James Kingsley rings him off. So the bullpen doing a nice job backing up the effort from their starter.
Yeah, we've seen some pretty excellent pitching out of this staff so far. I mean, they've come in ready to do their job and get outs. They've been pretty tough to get to in this one.
And now it's Austin Nola. That one's in there, 0-1. Next offering is in for a strike. And a swing and a miss, and that is the ball game.
Well, these guys just hadn't been playing fundamentally sound baseball, but today they put it together. This should start them rolling now. You have to pay attention to the details. If you do that with good pitching, good defense, you will win most of your ball games.
The 5-3 final score in this one. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Shambi. We'll see you soon.
For the victorious Diamondbacks, 5 runs on 9 hits, no errors. They left 10 men on base. For the Padres, 3 runs on 8 hits, 1 error. They left 7 men on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 4 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this evening. We remind you to please drive home safely.